We haven't seen each other for a while. First thing New Year, right? Happy New Year, all the blessings between 16 and the kind of, you know, we've got like these little lines that have also just been imprinted in us, and just kind of all the best, maybe prosperous, and you know, little rhymes, you know what I'm talking about, right? Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, be blessed. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, be prosperous. And we've got all these words, but the word I want to focus on this morning is new. What does the word new mean? What does it mean to be in the new year of the Lord? What does it mean to be in the new thing of the Lord? Now I'm going to read you a definition from Oxford Dictionary, just in case you thought I was making this up. Oxford Dictionary describes the word new as produced, introduced, or discovered recently or now for the first time. Say with me. Produced, introduced, or discovered recently or now for the first time. The word new also means not existing before.
Yes.
The way we sang last year is not the way we're going to sing this year.
Amen.
The way we pray last year is not the way we're going to pray this year.
Amen.
New means not existing before. Then they give you some more definitions, some synonyms. They talk about brand new up to the minute.
Yes.
How's that? The new song of the Lord that is supposed to be birthed from our mouth must be an up to the minute song.
Amen.
Because yesterday's song is an old song. If it's the song you sang before you left the house, it's an old song.
Yes.
We need to be singing the new song. We need to be focusing on the new. Isaiah 43:19 says, "Behold, I'm making all things new," which means it hasn't been made before.
Amen.
Haven't seen it before.
No.
People say, "Oh yeah, now I'm ready for the new. I'm ready for the new." But when the new looks like the new, you want the old. When the new doesn't fit the box in your mind, you're like, "Oh, I'm going to make the old." Stay with me now. in you now.
Yeah.
Right? The first thing that you have to do, you have to forget the former things. And not forget when you go back and visit it. And then cry and pat it back. Forget means forget.
Yes.
The mistakes.
Yes.
The this, the that, you name it. Mm. Forget the former things.
Yes.
We all make mistakes. Yeah. There's only one who's in his name is Jesus and he sits on the throne.
Amen.
So if you tell me you haven't made mistakes and everything is all good and da-da-da-da-da, then join him. Go. Ask him for a seat or squeeze him next to you on the hill.
I'll share it with you, Lord.
But that's not the case. Because we are in this world, we are subject to the challenges and to the emotions and all of these things of the world. But here's the thing, family. If you truly want to receive of the new thing, if you truly want to encounter the new thing, you've got to leave the past behind.
Yes. Oh, yes.
You've got to forget about the past. You cannot take past mistakes, past comforts. That's the biggest one.
Yes.
Those things that felt so good, those people that felt so good, and you know they're not supposed to be in your life.
Yes.
And now you want to drag them into your life.
Amen.
Oh, but I love you. Come with me. And they like. And you're like, oh, thank you. Forget the former things.
Amen.
That person who hurt you, that person, maybe you want some counseling, and Pastor says, I think you've got to leave this thing behind. I think you've got to move away from that situation, and Pastor goes on holiday and creep back in. And you snuggle in that situation. Whoa, feels good. It's a new year.
Yes,
ma'am.
And the Lord is doing a new thing.
Yes.
Which means that former things have to be left behind.
Amen.
How can the Lord reveal your future and your destiny when you still have, hey, who's there in the
back?
Hey, who's coming?
Yeah.
What? Who's?
Yeah.
And the Lord is showing you the path of your destiny, but you cannot see it.
Yes.
Because you're too busy in 2015.
Yes.
2014. Mm-hmm. 2013. Mm-hmm. 2006. Yep. And I can go back and back and back. And the Lord is saying, I'm doing a new thing.
Yeah.
Come on. See. In order to see the new thing, you have to be looking in the right place at the right time, not looking behind you.
Amen.
In order to see the new thing in the new year, the new move of God, you got to be in the right place at the right time. You've got to be where the new things are at.
Amen.
You've got to be where the new things are at.
Amen.
But most importantly, you've got to be ready to receive
yes.
the new thing. You've got to be ready. You've got to be hungry to say, Lord, it doesn't matter what the new thing looks like.
Amen.
We draw the new thing.
Yes.
And we give it to God. We draw the new thing based on the old thing.
Yeah.
Because that's all we know.
Yeah.
Amen. We draw the new thing based on the old thing and we give it to God. We're so proud of ourselves. Woo! We feel good. Family, new thing means new thing.
Yes.
New thing means it hasn't existed before.
Yes.
Don't go and put before the feet of God your old things that should have been left behind long ago. Oh, stubbornness. Yo! Some of us are dragging stubbornness, ne?
Yeah.
Ooh, it's firm, it's on our back. We're praying with our stubbornness. And every day we feed a little bit of water, a little bit of sunshine, and it grows. Our stubbornness grows in the drought. Stubbornness is, you know, it's all weather throughout that one.
Yeah.
Rain, shine, snow, our stubbornness, all that grows. The Lord says this, pastor says that. Now you're going to do the Lord says, go this way. You're like, no, Lord, no, no, no. The Lord says, don't go there. You're like, Maybe stubbornness is one of the things we've got to leave behind.
Yes.
Maybe stubbornness in our pride is one of the things that we've got to forget as a former thing. Because how can the Lord reveal a new thing to you if you're holding on to the comforts of the old?
Amen.
Yes.
New means new.
Yes.
New means new.
Yes.
It means you've never seen it before.
Yes.
It means it's advanced. It's up to the minute. It's new. It's current. The church should not be looking the same way today that we did even last week.
Yes.
Let alone 1,000 years ago. Let alone 50 years ago. Oh, but we love that model of the church, don't we? It's comfort. Oh, I know I got a church. I get a seat. Maybe next week there won't be no seats here.
Amen.
And then, what you going to do? What's your last or 3 years ago, 4 years ago, add anything to your life? No. What it will make you do, you'll miss out on the new thing.
Yes.
I've seen too many people turn away from the current move of God in the church, from the current way of the Holy Spirit, because they don't understand. Because it doesn't make sense to them why God is doing such a thing. Because they've never seen it before. I mean, we still think, you know, the spirit of joy, we think that's a new thing. Ow.
Yeah.
Ow. That's an old thing. That's an old thing. In the 1980s, 1990s, the Holy Spirit moved people. They even have a name. You guys know they couldn't know, you know. Now we're getting excited because it's new to us. But let me tell you what, the spirit of joy is the tip of the iceberg of the new things that God is
going to do.
And he's not looking back. We think that all of those generals that we've been studying in Nexus, we know, oh, that's exciting. It'll be nice if that happens. Why do you want something that happened 100 years ago? Why do you want to duplicate someone else's signs, wonders, and miracles? Why do you want to duplicate things that happened back then? Oh, that'll be nice, eh? Ooh, if we can maybe start like Mother Peter and be all in a show, that'll be lovely. Oh, I wish that would happen to us. Why? Why do you want the old thing? Is God not creative enough to give you a new thing? Is God not creative enough to create a new thing in the church? To give us new sounds, to give us new songs, to give us new sermons? The day that you hear me preach someone else's sermon, just come with your shotguns. I'll stand there. That is blasphemous. Blasphemous. How dare we duplicate someone else's stuff? Apostolism, we need to get more originals in this church. More original songs. Oh no, we need to be comfortable. Oh, that Bethel, oh, that court. And we snuggle in there in the Bethel seats. Oh, that little song, sure they move. And now we all want to duplicate, because that's what the church has become.
Yeah.
One big photocopy machine. It's true.
Yes.
The church has become one big photocopy machine, which means that Jesus is there in heaven every day. Copy and paste, copy and paste, copy and paste. Come on, church. That's you. That's not the Lord.
Yes.
I told you many times, I've been telling you for 3 years, those of you who are here for 3 years. I said, if you're boring, deal with it.
Yes.
Take a pull.
Yes.
Don't make my God boring.
Yeah.
If you're boring, I'm sure there's a course or something you can do.
Yes.
But don't you dare make my God boring. And don't you dare make my God copy and paste God. Jesus is not there with a photocopy machine. Reproducing the church.
Yes.
New thing means new thing.
Yes.
Amen. New thing means you've never seen it before.
Amen.
Don't live on the old thing and don't look for the old thing. Don't look for something in the church in your life that's going to make sense. Don't look for something you're going to understand. Don't look for something that you will have a picture of. Oh yes, I've seen that. Oh yeah, yeah, that church in America. Oh, it happened in America, then it's all good.
Yes.
Yeah. As long as it happens in America, that's a shame. Yeah, that's true. You were there. They were also like, oh, that's okay. Whew, I believe it. I thought it was strange. Yeah, it's true, eh?
Yes.
We look for the photocopy. And then we see the duplicate in the actually. New means
new.
This is 2016.
Yes.
Don't live like it's 2015. This is 2016. Don't think like it's 2015. Romans 12:2 says, do not conform to the pattern of the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Are we together?
Yes.
See, I am doing a new thing. Unfortunately, let's see. I won't even tell you what the Lord did with the leadership team yesterday. Was like 2 hours of pure power. Pure power. Which ended up in us having mud in our eyes and literally washing it off in the pool. Because the Lord says, my people do not see. My people are looking at this.
Amen.
What did the Lord do to Saul? Saul couldn't understand the new thing of God. Saul, Paul, he was trying to make a reference. He's like, these men are uneducated. This Peter is a fisherman. How can he preach of such a thing? Paul couldn't make sense of it in his mind. on the road to Damascus. We scolded him and we shut his eyes.
Yeah.
What did Jesus do to Paul on the road to Damascus? He scolded him. Why are you persecuting me? It is me, Jesus, you persecute. Now you're going to be blind. Because you are trying to make sense of this.
Yes.
You are trying to look with your natural eyes and think, oh, well, that person, well, that when they laugh, they roll. That means they got more of the spirit. That person sits on the tree, maybe it means they got legs. Do you see how they're sitting? Oh, okay. And that's what's going on. Yeah, now I got it down. The people sit on the 2 million rows get more of the spirit. Yeah. Why? Because we're looking, because now church is a show as well. We come to this assembly and we see what's going to happen. We're always entertained. Some of us. Did you see what happened? Like, you've got to come to my church because we watch what happens. That's what we say. We don't say come and experience. We can say come and see what happens. In other words, people must come with their glasses clean that day. They must get a good seat in the middle so they can get both sides. But let us see the wrong things. That is looking at the wrong things. Family, new means new.
Yes.
And I want to be with the newest that I heard about you. Yes. But one of the ways we've got to get to the new is we've got to see with our spiritual eyes. Stop looking. Stop looking at the things that you think are going to make sense to you. Stop looking at things and trying to figure out what is happening. Stop looking around, period. You know, the worst thing for me is in worship or we're praying and stuff and someone's phone goes off. Wow, I've never seen a person come out of the water faster than their phone goes off.
Yes.
You know, it's like light being seen in because we see more, we've been distracted. As a people, as a nation, as the globe, we are so easily distracted.
Yeah.
My word. What has happened to our desire to see the deep things of God?
Yes.
What has happened to our desire to see into the heavenlies where Jesus is? Wow, that thing comes out, forget Jesus. Who's this? Hey, who's bothering me when I'm in church? That's what y'all say? Am I right?
Yes.
Who's bothering me when I'm trying to praise? Trying to praise?
You're
trying to worship? Put the phone away. Don't worry about the person sitting next to you, to the left, to the right, to the front, to the back. Don't worry how hot it is. Maybe it's the glory of the Lord. But start looking beyond this. Stop making judgments and criticisms and decisions based on this. And ask the Lord to show you deep things. Ask the Lord to show you the new thing that is dreaming. That is current. It is always current. I am dreaming a new thing. Which is constantly always happening. Yet still, we have been the old. If Jesus is always and constantly and currently doing a new thing, then why aren't we seeing it? Why aren't we experiencing it as a church? Why aren't we seeing that transformation in our lives?
Yes.
Some of our lives are looking pretty much the same 4 years, 5 years in.
Yeah.
Even 2 weeks in. 3 months in. What is happening, people? What is happening with us that our lives are not looking new? What is happening to us that our mouths and our speech is not producing the new thing? What is happening that our thoughts are not producing new thoughts? For some of us, it's the same old thing, year in, year out, month in, month out. We eat the same old patterns. We've got to start allowing the Lord to transform, to renew us. But that only happens if we follow some instructions. New means new. Now it springs up. It's going to be like popping up the new thing of God. And because we're still looking at the past, we're not going to be expecting it.
Yes.
Because we're still looking for a model, for a picture that makes sense to us. We're going to miss the new thing happening right here.
Amen.
And we're going to miss it. Because we're looking back.
Mm-hmm.
Like, poof, the new thing. And what happened? Wait, new thing. Oh, I missed it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's happening to the church. More and more people are falling away because they are not looking with their spiritual eyes. So what the Lord is doing in the church is becoming stranger and stranger because poof, it happens and they blink. And they miss it. They come back 2-3 weeks later, it seems like the church is completely different. Come back a month later and the worship team is doing crazy things. People are dancing barefoot. You're like, yo, I was just away for a month. I was just away for 2 weeks. I was just away for a year. I was just away for 2 years. What happened? What happened? New means new.
Yes.
It springs up. When can you miss it? Stay away and slow and you miss it. Some people that come in, they visit now and again. Maybe people were with me there at the beginning my sermons were 5 minutes long. They were 5 minutes long and they were neat and they made me feel good. Like you went to a nice seminar. And like you got a nice patch at the end. Now they might come in there and say, yo, I've only been away for 2 years. What's happening here? This one is preaching for 2 hours. It makes me feel uncomfortable. I want to squirm it. I want to run. What's happening there? New means new.
Yeah.
Don't expect the same thing next week that happened this week.
Yes.
New means new.
Yes. Amen.
It springs up. Do you perceive it? You're not going to perceive it if you're not looking with your spiritual eyes.
Amen.
Yes. You're not going to be able to perceive it if you're still looking back at 2015. You're not going to see it, you're not going to perceive it, you're not going to acknowledge it.
Amen.
If you're looking back at yesterday.
Amen.
The Lord throws each one of our sins when we ask for forgiveness, Isaiah tells us, and he throws it into the sea of forgetfulness.
Yeah.
And he remembers it no more. And you say, oh, but Pastor, I can't forget. Oh, how can I forget? I can't forget. I just can't. Oh, God. If Jesus can, what's wrong with you?
Yeah.
Because we are created in his image and his likeness, am I right?
Yes.
So if we have characteristics of Jesus who forgets all of our sins every day, throws them into the sea of forgetfulness, don't come with those stories to me. It springs up. I am making a way in the desert, streams in the wasteland. The new means that new pathways will be formed. The new means that new leaders are rising up.
Yes.
The new means that new opportunities are going to be rising up because it's making a way where there was no way.
Yes. Amen.
It is making pathways where there were no pathways. What do we as people do? Where must I go? I don't see the path. Yeah, of course, this is new. The Lord wants you to make the path. Why can't we all be like Tata Madiba? Why? What is your path? He walked his path.
Yes.
90 something years, he walked it well. Get off the man's path. Come on now. Walk your own path. What has happened to us that we are so afraid to trust the Lord to walk on our parts of destiny?
Yes.
On our parts of victory? Oh no, well. Pastor did this, I was doing too. No, rubbish. Rubbish. Puke. Puke.
New means new.
New pathway.
Yes.
New pathway.
Yes.
In a week or two's time, we're going to ask people, we're going to invite people down the NMI. If you want to serve, you can serve, whatever. Oh, yeah, but it's okay, I'm cool. I've been serving in Ashland for 5 years, yeah? And then? what does that mean to me?
Yes.
What if the Lord wants to take you from the ashes and put you in the tech team? What if the Lord wants to take you from the tech team and put you in the kids ministry? New means new. Allow the Lord to make your path new.
Yes. Amen.
Don't come and tell me what you did.
Amen.
Tell me what you're going to do.
Amen.
Don't come and tell me your new thing. New thing means advanced, up to the minute, never been seen before. Lord, in Jesus' name, I want to come up against right now every spirit of religion, every spirit of legalism, every boundary, every barrier that will stop our people, will stop everyone in the sound of my voice right now from truly being hungry for the new thing. And every spirit of fear and confusion be removed right now in Jesus' name. And in our hearts, in our minds, in our thoughts, be geared towards seeing you and towards seeing the new thing in our lives. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Amen. I am making a way in the desert and streams in the wasteland. There's no way in the desert because it's full of sand. And sand gets blown over. Right? Footprints disappear very quickly in the desert. But God is not saying he's going to make footprints. That way there means a road. Something more concrete than just sand. What God is going to be asking of a lot of you, and probably has already started, is a new thing. Where you have not gone before. A new thing, new encounters, new levels of intimacy. God is always calling us into new levels of intimacy.
Yes.
Are we willing to respond to that new way that God wants to take us? You're going to hear in a few minutes' time that we're going to start our fasting on Friday, our 21-day annual fast that we do. And maybe you've never fasted, and you're comfortable that you've never fasted. But what does God want to do?
Yes.
Maybe God wants to create a new path in your life where fasting is included.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe God wants to create a new path in your life where maybe you attend more prayer sessions.
Yes.
Maybe God wants to attend a new pathway in your life where you commit to a serving area, where you commit maybe to outreaches. Maybe God wants to create a pathway in your life where you lead a home group in your community. But still, we look for the new thing. The old thing in the new thing. Oh, but I'm not going back to that old group. Oh, of course, it's changed just yet. Nothing will fix my freak than change, hey?
Yes.
Oh, but Lord, who are all these new people? Every week there's new people! That freaks my freak! I don't like change! Now someone sitting in my seat. Hey?
Yeah.
Okay?
No, not so freaky.
New music.
Amen.
If you visited today, next week you're not new, by the way.
Yes.
Truly?
Yes.
Now, welcome today. Enjoy the luxuries of today. Next week you're an old person. In order to receive and move into the new, you've got to come out from the bushes where you've been hiding from God.
Yes.
Amen.
No. You cannot see and experience and walk in the new when you are hiding behind a bush, saying, Lord, like Adam and Eve did, I made mistakes. Lord, I've sinned. Lord, I've done something wrong.
Yes.
Lord, I'm not worthy. Lord, this, Lord, that. The Lord called him. He said, where are you? He said, my creation, my people, my child, my son, my daughter, where are you? And they whispered, I'm here, Lord. I'm hiding. And the Lord says, well, you can read this in Genesis 2 or 3. And the Lord says, but why are you hiding? And he said, we've done something wrong. We aren't clothed properly. And the Lord says, who told you that? So I want to ask you in the family, who has told you that you are not fit for a certain part of God's kingdom?
Amen.
Who has told you? Who has lied to you? Human or demon, bring them to me. Bring them, I'll crash them.
Amen.
I'll crash. Because that is a lie straight from the pit of hell. That we cannot walk closer. We cannot be intimate. We cannot have a relation with the Lord because of things we did. Yes, they ate the apple or they ate the fruit. We know the story. They ate the fruit.
Yes.
But why not rather run to the Lord and say, forgive me?
Amen.
I don't want to lose that communion with you.
Yes.
I don't want to lose that. I want to walk with you again, Jesus. I don't want to hide behind bushes.
Yes.
I don't want the former things, the former eating of whatever fruit, the former drinking of whatever fruit drink. to get in the way of my relationship with you, Jesus. I want the new thing.
Yeah. Amen.
I don't want to be like Adam and Eve and all of those who continuously hide behind bushes. Step out. Yeah. Step out from among the bushes. Don't hide from God. Because when you hide behind the bush, you cannot take one step into your destiny.
Yes.
Amen.
When you hide from God, you cannot take one step into the future of the now.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Because you're stuck holding on to what feels safe, to what feels comfortable. But that is old. I don't know what God is going to do right now, but I want you to commit. And if you've been hiding behind bushes, you're going to come out from those bushes.
Amen.
Do not make the mistakes that people make who are living without grace.
Amen.
Do not make the mistakes that people make who think that they are living without the forgiveness of the Lord Jesus. Do not make the mistakes of people who are looking with their natural eyes.
Amen.
And they are only seeing their own faults. They are only seeing their own emptiness. Ron said, Lord, I don't want to be empty. I don't want to be clothed in garments of shame. I don't want to be wearing guilt. I don't want to be wearing my regrets. But Lord, I want God. I want heavenly clothes. I want royalty. I want clothes of righteousness. I want a garment of joy on me. I want to wear your armor. I want to be clothed in your peace. You got to come out from behind those bushes to experience the new thing. It will not look like anything you've seen before. Because new means
new.
Amen.
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 Let's all stand. Pastor Al, do you have something ready for us? Let's all stand. Lord, thank you for this word, my God. Thank you for speaking so clearly and so powerfully to me. Thank you, my God, that even right now the Holy Spirit is moving in conviction. Shaking loose old ways of thinking. Shaking loose and removing us from behind those bushes of hiding and shame and guilt. Holy Spirit, move. Just speak to us. Move in all the conviction and gentleness that you must to get us to react. To get us to make a decision to step out and to step onto the path of the now. To step out from behind and from hiding and to step onto the new thing that you are doing. Open our eyes, Lord. Open our eyes, remove scales that are blocking us from seeing the new thing. We want to perceive it. We want to see it springing up. We want to. We want the new thing in this new year, in this new season, in this new month, on this new day. We want it. In Jesus' name, I pray.
Amen.
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 Holy Jesus. Holy Lord. There's no better place to be, Lord, than in sweet surrender to you. There's no safer place to be, Lord, in surrender to you. And there's no more peaceful place to be where we say yes. Yes, Lord, I want the new. Yes, Lord, come now. Renew me, redeem me for all that you want to do in my life. Thank you, my God, for a wonderful time in your presence. Thank you for each person who's here. Thank you for each person who's here and hungry. Thank you for each person whose life you already are transforming and renewing. New means new, Lord.
Yes.
New means new, and we're not turning back.
Yes.
The past is the past, and the past is gone.
Yes.
The past is the past, and the past is old.
Yes, Lord.
And we are saying to you right now, King Jesus,
yes.
New means new.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Let your grace, your love, your peace, your joy, the hope that is in you, descend right now, fill our thoughts, fill our hearts, fill our actions, fill our words, fill our thinking, fill our coming and our going, till we meet again. In Jesus' name I pray.
Jesus' name.